This lesson is going to cover alternate picking. Alternate picking is a technique or a method or a way to be able to play a series of notes or a series or string of notes consecutively, one after each other, whether you're playing like a riff or a solo. With our previous lessons, we didn't worry about what your right hand was up to at all. We just were focusing on the left hand. So let's dig in. The purpose of this lesson is to help you develop your right hand, or your picking hand, and then also the sync that exists between both your left and right hands. And we're talking about a couple other exercises that'll really push your left hand and make it work a little bit harder, which will then challenge, again, that sync between the two hands. And there's a little bit of a push and pull there, and so it takes some time to kind of develop. So the important thing here is that we're doing what we call kind of strict alternate picking. There's different ways of being able to play strings of notes or lines of notes in either a solo or a riff, either using sweep picking or hybrid picking, or there's other techniques. With this one, we're just worrying about strict alternate picking, and that means going down, up, 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 down, up. So we're never going to do two downs or two ups in a row. You just want to be firing away. Down, up, 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 down, up. Now, what I was doing with my left hand was just playing four notes in a row. I was starting on fifth fret. With most beginner guitar players, I like to kind of get away from the first fret kind of early on a little bit. It's a little easier to play in the middle part of the neck, and anything you can do to give yourself a little bit of positive reinforcement is a good thing, especially early on. Learning a new instrument is challenging enough. You don't want to be judgmental. If it sounds bad, it's going to sound bad. That's just part of the process. Even Jimi Hendrix sounded bad when he first started. That's okay. So don't be judgmental, or don't put yourself down. So it was four notes in a row. I was going one, two, three, four, and I played just across all six strings the exact same shape. Just like our basic warm-up was the same frets all the way across. We're just adding more notes to it, or smashing all of those together. Now, once you get up on the first string, you want to add in a small slide. So it was 5, 6, 7, 8, then I bump up one fret and then play it backwards, four frets. 9, 8, 7, 6. Do that all the way backwards, and then bump up one fret again, or you could actually slide back down and start to where you began. I usually like to keep creeping up the neck. That way you start to get used to playing on the little frets of the guitar, or the smaller frets of the guitar. Then bump up. Then bump up. So that's alternate picking exercise number one. Just four notes in a row, all the way across all six, up one fret, four notes all the way back, and then shift up again. The next exercise, or number two, is going first finger, pinky, ring, and then middle. Now, the alternate picking still stays the same. We're just changing the combination with your left hand. That's going to make it a little bit more challenging. So it's going to be first finger, pinky, ring, middle, or 1, 4, 3, 2, next string. Next string. Down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up. Then from here, same thing, just shift up and then do the opposite. So 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. And then start over again. That's number two. Then number three is going to be splitting our hand in half. So we're going to go 1, 2, 4, 3. 1, 2, 4, 3. kind of finger gymnastics when we're really not playing scales, I would urge you to not play them too much. You don't want to get too hung up with this kind of a thing. This is just a nice way of, if you're going to get warmed up, you want to try to get your, well, you want to try to get your practicing fairly organized. So, like if you were gonna lift weights, you would get warmed up and then stretch and then do the meat of your whatever your workout was. Same sort of thing here. We're just trying to get your two hands warmed up, ready to go, ready to play, and then, you know, go ahead and move on to something else that's a little bit more musical, I think. But they're really nice exercises to push, especially beginner guitar players, and I still use them actually like before an original show to help me get warmed up, just to kind of get the blood flowing, get your body temperature up, and get everything ready to go, especially with our original music. There's a lot of alternate picking in what in our music, so that's a nice sort of way of just kind of getting the cobwebs knocked off and getting ready to play without necessarily having to be plugged in and really hearing yourself. You can just be, you know, kind of in the back getting ready to go. And then, you know, then you'll be ready to play and execute, you know, all that crazy technical, you know, kind of stuff. Hope you enjoyed the lesson. Please hit like or subscribe if you did, and feel free to look around on our channel and check out our original music. We have our full EP up for to stream, which we released this past March, as well as other music videos and fun kind of goofy things. Bye.